Hello friends, today we are going to learn how to create a VHDL code for 4:1 marks and D flip flop. So we need the software by Xilinx. So we are going to open ISC environment for it. We have to first click on new project. We have to give a project name, so I'm making it as mux41. We have to see that top level source type is HDL and click on next. We have to see that the family selector is Spartan 3, not Spartan 3 or 2e or any other. We have to see that it's Spartan 3. After that, we have to see that preferred language is VHDL, not very low. So after checking all these things, we are gonna click on next. We'll be shown the project summary, so we're gonna click again next, finish. In this window, we have to right click on this project and click on new source. In the select source type wizard, we have to click on VHDL module and give it another file name which is different from the project name. Like mux41. We have to then click on next. This is the define module wizard. We have to see that architecture name is behavioral because we are using this style of modeling. We have to give the port name. Port names are the inputs to the multiplexer, the select lines and the outputs of the multiplexer. So we are giving the inputs as I0, I1, I2, I3, select line S and output Y. We have to see the direction is in for inputs I0, I1, I2, I3 and S, but as we are giving output from Y, we are going to choose the direction as out. Since it is a 4:1 mux, there will be two select lines and 4 inputs. So we'll click on bus, make MSB as 1 and LSB as 0. This is a vector from 0 to 1. Since there will be select lines S0 and S1. Now since if it was a 8:1 mux, then we would have written as 2 0 3 0, because there will be 4 select lines and 8 inputs, S0, S1, S2 and S3. So as we are doing it for 4:1 mux, we are making MSB as 1 and click next. This is the summary. Then we have to again click finish. This is the pre-written code by this application. So after we are done with this, we are gonna write the code for the multiplexer. I have already written the code for the multiplexer, so I'm just gonna copy it. I'm gonna include in the video at the comment section. Here is the code for VHDL. We are just gonna copy it. And paste it over here. After this, we are done with it. Then, with this, we have to click on synthesize. Double click on it. Do you want to say yes? It will take some time. Since there is a green arrow mark, it shows that code runs and it is all right. Now we can see the RTL schematic for this by double clicking on it. We have to click this on OK. We have to add the element from the available element, that is mux41. After this, we are done with this. We have to click on create schematic. This is the RTL schematic. We can see the different models by double clicking on it. Okay. Now we are done with this. We have to make the simulation of this mux. So we are gonna close all these files. Yeah. Here. As you can see, in the view section here, it is already clicker implementation. Now we want the simulation of the 4:1 mux. So we gonna click on the simulation. After that, we are done with this. We again click on this, right click, and new source. In this new source wizard, now we have to click on VSDL test bench, not VSDL module. So we are going to give a name to this test bench, like MuxDB. Then click on next. Associate a source. We are gonna click on MUX41. It's already selected. Then we are gonna click on next. Finish. Again, this code window will be open. Now, since MUX does not have a clock, we are gonna comment out all the clock lines. We can do this by clicking on this button, comment selection button, or by pressing two hyphens. We are gonna just select it and click comment it out. Now, as you can see, this is a stimulus process. We have to clear all the data from here and copy the codes for the multiplexer. And just paste it over here. After that, we are done with this. We have to click on this and processes. We have to check the behavioral syntax. Click on this. See, now behavioral syntax is green mark. So our code for the simulation is perfect. Now we have to click on stimulate behavioral model. Now since this is a Windows 10 PC, this process will not be able to do because the software was not designed for Windows 10 and Windows 8. But in Windows 10, you will be able to simulate the multiplexer. Thank you.